I'm Dr. Andrea Alu, and I'm an associate professor at the University of Texas in Austin, Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering. Along the years, I always was fascinated in understanding how phenomena, wave, light interaction works, and how waves propagate in different materials. That's where my studies went. After I got my master's in Italy, I got the opportunity to spend 1 year abroad to explore any field of research that I wanted. And that's how I landed into University of Pennsylvania, and I started working with these metamaterials. What's interesting of these metamaterials at that time was that the field was just starting. There were a lot of open questions, open challenges. I remember vividly that when I went there was an open discussion, even if negative refraction, one of the landmarks of metamaterials, was even physically possible. And personally, I'm really intrigued and interested by questions like this one, right? Is it physically possible or feasible to build a material that can refract light the wrong way? At that time, there were papers written arguing that this would violate some fundamental laws of physics. And along the years now, we have come to realize what's possible and what's not. And many things are possible that probably contradict the fundamental rules of natural materials that you can find in old books. Because metamaterials have really opened new perspectives on what technology can achieve. Light is one of the first things that humans have see and are able to appreciate. So since prehistory, humans have been fascinated by controlling and being able to use light for many activities. In the last few centuries, there have been a lot of studies in trying to understand the laws that light follows to and the laws of optics. In particular, in the last century, we've done a lot of progress in understanding the theory of light propagation and how our eyes interact with light to be able to see. Nanotechnology helps us to make these tools much more advanced, and we can control and play with light at a much higher level. The whole field of optical metamaterials, or artificial materials that can control light in unprecedented ways, is the field behind our studies and our research. This topic has been of fascination and of interest since ancient times. In fact, in novels and poems, since long before optical laws were discovered, there was a lot of imagination on how we could make objects or persons invisible to the human eye. Today, with the advent of metamaterials, we have been able to manipulate light at a new level, and therefore we are able to come up with the right technology that allows us to at least suppress significantly the scattering from objects, and therefore be able to, in principle, make an object invisible. The idea of cloaking is to take an object and be able to wrap it with a cloak or a cover that suppresses the scattering or the interaction of this object with a wave, such that the wave can go through the object without scattering and without, therefore, letting it be visible. To see an object, we need to be able to pick up a portion of the light energy that hits the object. If we're able to cancel or to suppress all the scattered energy, then the object will be, by all means, invisible. Our eyes or our sensors, like optical sensors that can image an object, like a camera, are able to pick up the waves that come off the surface of this object. In fact, if an object does not scatter any wave, like a transparent glass, for instance, our eyes are not able to see the presence of that object. Metamaterials is interdisciplinary, so we look at things that can benefit nano-optics, chemistry, biology, medicine, and engineering, of course. In the long run, what our main goal is to really make an impact on practical technology with all these ideas and come up with devices that can be in our everyday technology. We hope really to impact all these different fields of science, and that's what all my students and myself are doing.
Because I'm looking very far away.
I think we need as a society educated people that understand how physics and engineering really works, and it can benefit everyone, even in terms of politics and for where our country is directed. So I like that we can use our science. I mean, we are having fun mostly, we are answering for ourselves our questions, but if this can help also engage students and society on a broader level, it's really nice.